हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ लेक्चर 4 ऑफ सीरीज ऑफ रोलिंग कॉन्टैक्ट बियरिंग। सो माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर आशीष गुप्ता, आई एम एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग इन जे एल वी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट एट ग्रेटर नोएडा। सो इन लास्ट लेक्चर्स वी हैव कवर्ड इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट एंड द स्टैटिक लोड और स्टैटिक इक्विवेलेंट लोड। इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल कवर विद द बेसिक डायनेमिक लोड्स, डायनेमिक इक्विवेलेंट लोड, रेटेड लाइफ, इक्विवेलेंट डायनेमिक लोड विद वेरिएबल लोड कंडीशंस, रिलायबिलिटी ऑफ बेयरिंग एंड लुब्रिकेशन ऑफ बेयरिंग्स। सो आफ्टर दिस लेक्चर आई विल कम टू डायरेक्टली कम टू द न्यूमेरिकल पार्ट। इन 4 लेक्चर्स आई हैव कवर्ड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल थियोरेटिकल एंड एनालिटिकल पार्ट्स। सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द लाइफ ऑफ अ बॉल बेयरिंग, विच इज कैन बी लिमिटेड बाय द फटीग फेलियर एट द सरफेस ऑफ द बॉल्स एंड रेसेस। सो सिमिलरली हेयर द डायनेमिक लोड कैरिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ द बेयरिंग इज ऑल्सो बेस्ड ऑन द फटीग लाइफ ऑफ द बेयरिंग। सो बेसिकली वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड द लाइफ ऑफ द बेयरिंग और लाइफ ऑफ द इंडिविजुअल बॉल बेयरिंग is defined as the number of revolutions or hours of service which the bearing runs before the first evidence of the fatigue may be in terms of cracks or cracks in balls or races. So it has been observed that the life of a single bearing is difficult to predict. So it is necessary to define the life in terms of the statistical average performance of a group of bearings. So the bearing the bearing can be rated in 2 criteria. First criteria is to find the average life of a group of bearings, and second is the life which 90% of bearings will reach or exceed. So these are the 2 main criteria. I repeat again, the first criteria is to find out the average life of a group of bearing, or you can find the life where bearings or maximum number of bearings reached at least 90% of life. So in industry basically we are using second criteria. So we can say the rating, dynamic rating, or the rating life of a group of identical ball bearings is defined as the number of revolutions that 90% of the bearings will complete or exceed before the evidence of the crack. So here these are the basic formula where you can find the dynamic load rating of roller contact bearing. So in first criteria you can find through IS 3824. So according to this standard, the basic dynamic radial load rating for radial and angular contact ball bearing with balls not larger than 25.4 millimeter in diameter, and we use this formula C equal to FC I cos alpha the whole power 0.7 Z 2 by 3 D 1.8. If the ball size is larger than 25.4 millimeter in diameter, then we use this formula, second formula. So this formula you can find in your machine data handbook, and the notations may be different, but you find the machine rating headings and compare this formula with the machine data handbook formula you can use. So for these formulas are used for a radial ball bearing, similarly for radial roller bearing, similarly for thrust ball bearings. Here thrust ball bearings we have 4 criteria: 4 balls not larger than 25.4 millimeter in alpha equal to 90 degree, So use these formulas according to, so according to standards, you can use all these formulas according to the as per your diameter size and alpha angle. Similarly for thrust wall bearing, so you see the data handbook. If you have any problem, then you can write on a comment box. I will cover machine data handbook part in my next lecture. So the next part is dynamic equivalent load. This part is also similar to the static equivalent load. In the last lecture we have discussed that in actual applications, where the force which is acting on a bearing which has two components, one is your radial and another one is your thrust. So it is necessary to convert these two components acting on a bearing into a single hypothetical load which fulfill the conditions which is applied to the dynamic load carrying capacity. So the this equivalent dynamic load or this hypothetical load may be defined as the constant radial load in radial bearings or thrust load in thrust bearings, which if applied to the bearing would give same life as that which the bearing will attain under actual conditions of forces. So the expression you can see here, in this expression you can see the Wx into V Wr plus by into Wa. So here V is a rotation factor which is depend on the type of bearing. For example, if V you are taking 1 and this is applicable for all type of bearing, then the inner race is rotating and the outer race is fixed. You can take 1.2, which is also all type of bearing except self-aligning, when inner race is stationary and outer race is rotating. So this formula you can also find from your machine data handbook. So here, and the x and y are the constants, x and y are the radial and thrust factors, and the values of these factors you can find in table which is available in coming two slides. So you can find the value of x and y, and where wr and wa are the radial load and the axial or thrust load. So from this table you can find the value of x and y. So here the value of xy depends on the value of e. You can assume as a you can assume from the hit and trial error method. So this value vary as per the type of bearings. So next part is load life relationship. So basically the relationship between the dynamic load carrying capacity and the dynamic equivalent dynamic load and the bearing life, you can see the relationship here. L equal to C upon W, where W is your equivalent load and C is your dynamic load capacity, and where K is the factor which depend the values of K. You can see here it's depend on the type of bearing. If it is if you are taking ball bearing, then the value of K will be 3, and if you are taking roller bearing, the value of 10 by 3. So here is the L is the rating life, so C dynamic load capacity, and W is your dynamic equivalent load. So basically if the life is given in revolutions and the life in working hours, so the relationship between the life in revolutions and the working hours is here. And so here you can find the life in revolutions, and you put in the first equation so that you will get the value of बेसिक डायनेमिक लोड रेटिंग और इक्विवेलेंट डायनेमिक लोड. सो द नेक्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट इज द सर्विस फैक्टर विच इज यूज फॉर अ रेडियल वॉल बेयरिंग. सो यू मल्टीप्लाइड दिस फैक्टर विद द डायनेमिक रेडियल लोड सो यू विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ बेसिक डायनेमिक रेडियल लोड. सो हेयर दीज आर द वैल्यूज ऑफ सर्विस फैक्टर एंड इट्स रिप्रेजेंटेड द के एस. इट मे बी डिफरेंट इन योर डेटा सो यू कैन फाइंड on the service factor. So here for type of service, it's the value of service factor depends on the type of service. So for uniform and steady load, the value of KS is 1. For light shock load, value is 1.5. Moderate shock load, value is 2. If the service is given, then you can select accordingly. Otherwise, you can choose anyone. Generally, we are considering moderate shock load. So, generally, the value of KS is taken 2. Otherwise, if there is if a value is not given, then you choose 3rd. Otherwise, given, then do accordingly. So now come to the very important part is the selection of bearing or basic design steps for bearing. So how to choose bearing? So first we have to calculate the radial and axial force acting on the bearing and determine the dia of the shaft where the bearing is to be fitted. So in this part we have to calculate the dia and find the radial or axial force acting on the bearing. Generally these forces are given in numerical problem. Either a radial force is given, either axial force is given, or both forces are given. In next step you have to calculate the type of bearing for the given application. So if this part is also given in your numerical problem, if this part is not given, then you can arbitrarily select the any kind of ball bearing or roller contact bearing. So in the next part, in step 3, you have to calculate the value of x and the y. So these factors you can select from the table where you have to choose the axial or radial force, or either you can find through the axial force or the static force. So in last slides you can see the table where you can find the value of E. If for a particular bearing section, if suppose we are considering a deep groove bearing, so here the value of E is maximum 0.44. So here first you calculate the ratio of axial thrust or radial force, or either you can choose the axial thrust or upon static load capacity. So find out the ratio for that, then compare with the E. If the value of that ratio is greater than 0.44, then you choose to second column, or either if this value is under range, then you choose first column. So here you can find the value of X and Y. So in next step you can see you have to choose the calculate the dynamic load, equivalent dynamic load from the equation. Equation is already given in last slides. And next step you have to take a decision about the expected bearing life in terms of the you have to select the expected bearing life, which is also formula dependent. So in next step calculate the dynamic load capacity. And in last step you have to select the bearing of series 60, the required dynamic capacity. So here you can find the dynamic load capacity or dynamic load capacity, so that you can choose the bearing number as per diameter, whatever diameter you calculate in first step and or given in numerical problem, or dynamic load capacity and choose the number. If you have a 4 or 5 number, then you can select arbitrary any one of number, right? So here I will also explain through a one numerical problem. Suppose we have a problem. We have a one numerical problem. So in this it is required to, in this problem, you can see it is required to select a single row deep group ball bearing for a shaft diameter 75 millimeter and rotates at 125 rpm. So here diameter is already given and the rotation is 125 rpm. So the bearing is subjected to a radial load of 21 kilonewton. Okay, and there is no thrust load. So it is already given, there is no thrust load. So then the value of PR will be zero. And the PA is equal to zero. And PR is given 21 kilonewton. So the expected life of the bearing is also given 10,000 hours. So in step first, you have to calculate the radial force and axial thrust load and diameter. So it is already given in your numerical. So step two, I have taken this problem from Bhandari book, B.B. Bhandari book. So notation may be different, but you have to follow only our last notations or as per your data handbook. So in step second, you have to choose the bearing type. So here single row deep group ball bearings already given, right? So in step third, you have to choose the equivalent load. So here FA is zero, then you can directly select FR, P equal equivalent load. So 21,000 newton. It will be equal to your radial load. And step 4, you have to calculate the value of expected bearing life. So here you choose, in step 4 you find the value of C in dynamic load, in terms of dynamic load capacity. So the value of dynamic load capacity is 88,560.43 newton. In last step, you choose the value of bearing number as per your dynamic load capacity. So here table is given, table 15.5. So here dia is given, dia is your already given 75 millimeter. So you choose for 75 millimeter dia and the dynamic load capacity 88,560 newton. You choose four numbers, number 6015, 6215, 6015, 6415. So these four numbers are for 75 millimeter bore diameter and your load capacity is 88,560.43. So it comes in third number, 6315. Then you choose the bearing type, your 6315. So that will be your bearing. So the next part is the equivalent dynamic load for roller contact bearing under variable load. So till now we have considered the equivalent dynamic load is constant. Now the load is varying. So here we have considered W1, W2, W3, three variable loads for the successive conditions N1, N2, N3. These are the number of revolutions respectively. So here load is varying as per revolutions, right? So if the bearing is operated at constant load W1, so first we determine the equivalent dynamic load at W1, at W2, similarly for W2, similarly for W3. So here this is the whole derivation. You would no need to learn or solve because the last expression is will you will already find your last expression in your data handbook. So no need to learn this formula, and but notations may be different, so you do as per your data handbook. So the reliability of a bearing, or we can say the probability of survival. So in the last slide we have already discussed that the rating life is the life that 90% of group of identical bearings will complete or exceed before the first evidence of fatigue develops. So the reliability may be defined as the ratio of number of bearings which have successfully completed L million revolutions. to the total number of bearings under test. So basically, till now we have considered only those bearings which complete 90% of a group of identical bearings, the rating life of 90% of a group identical bearings before the first evidence of fatigue. So here, if it is required that the bearing reliability more than 90%, so for this we select the formula of Bebole. So according to Bebole, the relation between the bearing life and the reliability is given as, which is already mentioned in your data handbook, so that here you have to put the value of R. L you can find from the rating life formula, and the value of R is the reliability. So here A and B are the constants. So generally the value of these constants are equal to A equal to 6.84 and B equal to 1.17. So you consider, suppose you need to choose a bearing which having a reliability more than 90% is L. L90 is your a group of identical bearings which complete before the first evidence of fatigue. So these are the reliabilities R and R90 accordingly. So you can find the bearings which having the reliability more than 90%. So here you can find directly from the figure probability of failure if you know the ratio of L upon L10. So here you can see the two curves. First curve is actual test data and second curve is the Bebole distribution. So here you can find the probability of failure in terms of percentage. So lubrication of ball and roller bearings. So first you know the purpose, what is the important purpose why use lubrication roller and the ball bearings. So first is to reduce the friction and wear between the sliding parts of the bearing. Generally inner race and the outer race is come mating with the balls. So the purpose of lubrication is to reduce friction between balls and inner race, or balls or outer race, and it also prevent rusting or corrosion of the bearing surfaces. It can also protect the bearing surface from the butter dirts, and it also used to dissipate the heat. So the basic lubrications which is generally used in these bearings, oil or light grease is generally used to lubricating ball and roller bearings. Generally pure mineral oil or calcium based grease is generally used, and if there is possibility of moisture contact, then we add potassium and sodium based grease. So these are the lubrications which is used for ball and roller bearings. So